Inflation in the eurozone is at the lowest level in 4 years. This is raising concerns that the region is at risk of deflation, just like we've seen in Japan. So for Saxo Bank's Nick Beecroft, the message is clear. He wants to see more from the ECB.
I think it's pretty serious. I think matters are finally coming home to roost for the eurozone. The option which is prescribed are many years of austerity, labour market reforms, which in the end may, if they stay the course, have the effect of increasing competitiveness. But unfortunately, I'm not sure they will have the political will to stay the course. I am really reminded of the Bank of Japan's failure to take bold actions in the 1990s, when it was obvious that Japan was sliding into deflation.
Worries over low inflation prompted the ECB to cut rates last week, one of the reasons why the euro dropped. But Nick thinks that this is not enough.
What would be really needed to make the euro decline in value would be a cut in the deposit rate. That would really show that the ECB had finally got the message. In some senses, although Thursday was a surprise, a lot of people were expecting it in December, so it's only a month early, and we still didn't get a deposit rate cut, we still didn't get another introduction of a long-term LTRO. Those measures have to come, I think.
This week we get CPI inflation figures out of Germany and France. So will they be able to trigger any action from the ECB?
And if we do see a looming deflation problem in Germany and or France, then that's really possibly going to save the day, so to speak, and actually spur the ECB into action.